Hello everyone, today we are going to start with antibiotics. We use suffix capital A and small x in our practice. Now there are four principles that antibiotic works on. First one is bactericidal, which means any substance or any product which kills the bacteria completely. Cidal means killing and bacteria means bacteria. The second principle is bacteriostatic. It means any product or substance which will stop the growth of the bacteria, which will stop the reproduction of the bacteria. Third principle is synergistic. We use this term when the combined effect of two drugs is higher than the individual effect. For example, we have penicillin and aminoglycosides. When we use these drugs individually, the effect is less. But if we will combine these two drugs, the desired effect will be higher. The fourth principle is antagonistic. For example, we are using drug penicillin and tetracycline together, but we are not getting the desired effect. The desired effect is less than the individual effect of penicillin and tetracycline. We'll call this principle as antagonistic. Now we'll start with mechanism of actions. There are four mechanisms of actions on which antibiotic works. First one is inhibition of cell wall synthesis. Second one is inhibition of protein synthesis. Third one is inhibition of nucleic synthesis. And fourth one is inhibition of folic acid synthesis. Now there are various drugs which works according to the different mechanism of actions here. Drugs, for example, penicillin, cephalosporins and vancomycin works by inhibiting cell wall synthesis. Drugs such as macrolides and chloramphenicol works by inhibiting protein synthesis. Drugs such as fluoroquinolones and rifampicin works by inhibiting nucleic synthesis. Drugs such as sulfonamides works by inhibiting folic acid synthesis. I'll explain about this in further videos. Let's talk about penicillin for now. Now, as you can see in this point, penicillin works by inhibiting cell wall synthesis. Let's remind you about the biochemistry. Cell wall is composed of cross-linked polymers of polysaccharides and pentapeptides. So cell wall is made up of polysaccharides and pentapeptides. This drug interacts with PBPs. Now what is this PBPs? You need to know this PBP. This is cytoplasmic membrane binding proteins. The function of this is it stops the transpeptidation reaction. If we stop this reaction, there will be no crosslinks. If there will be no crosslinks, there will be no cell wall synthesis. I'll repeat once again. Penicillin interacts with PBPs. PBPs are known as cytoplasmic membrane binding proteins. The function of this protein is it inhibits the transpeptidation reaction. If we inhibit this reaction, there will be no cross-linking. If there will be no cross-linking, there will be no cell wall synthesis. This is how penicillin works. Now we can classify penicillin into four types. Narrow spectrum penicillins, very narrow spectrum, broad spectrum, and extended spectrum. You need to remember the names and the organism that it works against. In the narrow spectrum, examples are penicillin G and penicillin V. It works against organisms such as meningococcus, streptococcus, and pneumococcus. In very narrow spectrum, drugs such as methicillin and oxacillin works against staphylococcus. In broad spectrum, drugs such as ampicillin and amoxicillin, both starting from A, works against E. coli and H. pylori. When there is some gastric ulcer or gastritis, we'll give ampicillin and amoxicillin. Extended spectrum consists of piperacillin, which works against organism Pseudomonas aeruginosa. You need to memorize this one. Then what are the side effects of penicillin? The most common side effect is hypersensitivity reaction. Now, the hypersensitivity reaction occurs of all four types, from 1, 2, 3, and 4. Another side effect is gastrointestinal distress. We are giving amoxicillin or ampicillin for E. coli and H. pylori. This can also cause GI distress. If we are giving it in excess amount, it will cause gastrointestinal distress as a side effect.